Hello and welcome back to one final Law of the Chosen Class Guide. Today we're going to be looking at the Psionics class. And actually we're not going to be looking at them very much, because this is the one video where we're not going to be even going into the game, but this is just going to be a wiki exercise. Because the class obviously works a little bit different. So when you train your Psionic for the first time in the Psylab, they get the four baseline abilities, which is Soulfire, Insanity, Mind Merge, and Quick Study. Then they need to level up, basically earn XP on missions and promote. And when they promote, then you get to teach them one additional ability. I think you always get a set of abilities to choose from. I don't just think that is the way. So there's a little bit of randomness involved there, and there's also some requirements. So if you look at these overall abilities, this little tree, professional production value, shows you the requirements. So basically, you need to train Solace if you ever want to get Nolens. You need to train Fortress to get Bastion. That just kind of makes sense. You need to train Fuse if you want to get Stasis or if you want to get Domination. Soulsteel is required for Null Ward or Void Rift. And Facewalk is required for Soulstorm. So, what are good pickups? What are good abilities here? Because you can't get them all. So, in my opinion, Fuse obviously is a really strong pickup. It's a free action. It explodes enemy grenades. It's just good to have, right? This is for me like a kind of an pretty much an instant pickup. If I see that. It also has the big advantage of leading into Stasis and Domination, which are probably also like the things you really want to have. Domination can change the outcome of a battle, swing the balance in a match in a huge way. Stasis, keep in mind, Stasis has been nerfed. You cannot use Stasis on large enemies, which means no Sector Pods, no Gatekeepers, no Chrysalid Queens. Anything else is free one-turn stun on Stasis, no counter to that, but those three big guys you have to solve in a different way. Then Facewalk has very interesting, it's a very interesting skill. Let's quickly switch back here. So if we look at the skill description, phase out existence, teleport to a nearby location. Now, nearby is surprisingly large, so you can teleport to any tile that is within your squad's line of sight and within 27 tiles of the starting position of the soldier. Which is, of course, a huge radius. It's a huge mobility boost. And, well, first of all, it allows you to catch up with the squad in a very easy way. It does not break concealment, by the way, so it allows you to set up the perfect null lands, the perfect void rift to open up on a group of enemies. It also allows for an alternative Psy play where I was giving my psionic soldiers a shotgun and just face walk next to an enemy, shotgun to the face. Always nice to have. Of course, you don't have any multi-shot abilities, you don't have rapid fire, you don't have any crit boosting abilities. So you're not going to be a run and gun or face walk and gun assault trooper, but especially early game, this can be fairly effective. The one ability that I'm not convinced of on the list here is probably Soulstorm, which Phase Walk leads into. Meteor of Psionic Energy deal damage to enemies inside a target area and destroy their cover. Now, this target area is always based on your soldier. So, the soldier is the center, and like 5-tile radius, I think it is, around you, you damage enemies. And 4-tile radius it is. And destroy cover, or rather have a chance to destroy cover. It ends your turn, so if you're destroying cover in a 4-tile radius around you, you're standing there out in the open. So, on the other hand, sometimes it doesn't destroy cover, so it was kind of, in the way I tried it, not very reliable in what it was doing, and the damage wasn't enough to justify the risk to your soldier. So I think Soulstorm is, for me, a pick to avoid, especially since all the other abilities are so good, so it's kind of, you always have a good alternative to pick up and leave Soulstorm out of it. Now, there is also, if we go back to the requirements, you can, if you really just want to be offensive, in a way ignore the green part, because I don't, Void Rift does very little damage. Its main appeal is the secondary effect, where you have a chance to disorient, panic, or mind control enemies hit by the Void Rift. But overall, if you just want to pick up the rest of the package here, and you have your Null Lance as your main actual damage dealing ability, you can kind of ignore the green stuff and maybe even the purple, and pick your Psy abilities based on these kind of things. And that makes for a really strong trooper. What else? Maybe worth mentioning the psionic stat of your soldier. So each soldier has a psi rating, which kind of corresponds also to the combat intelligence. So it uses the same pool of points during character creation. Either they have high combat, everybody who has high combat intelligence also has high psionic, because psionic has no use for combat intelligence. So that's the way it's balanced. The thing is, though, there's only three abilities that benefit at all from your psi rating, which is insanity, chance to inflict disorient, panic, mind control on enemies, right? Mind merge, giving a buff to a friendly player. Now, these are also two baseline abilities, just keep that in mind. So the amount of willpower, crit chance, and a play for hit points is based on your psi stat. I think in the advanced tooltip we even see the exact numbers. One crit per 7 psi, one willpower per 5 psi, and one shield point per 20. So you can kind of aim for certain breakpoints there. And then there's of course domination, which granted is one of the strongest abilities on the tree. And then to a certain effect, of course, what I just mentioned, Void Rift, and the secondary effect from Void Rift, where you have a chance to cast Insanity on each one of those. So a lot of people say, hey, Psy stat doesn't matter because only three abilities benefit from it. On the other hand, those three abilities are kind of strong, especially Domination, but you can certainly build a Psy Trooper with low Psy stat, and then just go for the more guaranteed damage abilities, like Null Lance, like Soulfire, like Fuse, and then support abilities like Stasis, Bastion, and also Null Ward. I think especially having, well, Fortress as a requirement and then Bastion there, gives a really, really strong buff to your team. Like, everybody close to psionic is immune to fire, poison, acid, and explosive damage, which allows you to almost nullify enemy mechs. You can just group up, they will micro-missile you, and you are immune to explosive damage. You don't take no damage from that. Andromedons, throwing the acid bomb, don't care, immune to acid. Viper Spit, immune to poison. Even to an effect where if someone is on fire, you can run the psionic close to them and the Bastion Aura will remove existing fire. So really, I can't recommend that enough. It solves a lot of problems, especially considering how strong the fire debuff is in the game. So just keep in mind though, all purifiers starting from the advanced purifier, have the phosphorus, I think it's called, perk, which ignores fire immunities. So they can't set you on fire because you're immune to that, but they will still damage you. So don't ignore purifiers. Could get a bit of a bad awakening. Finally, what about officer? Is it viable to make a psionic an officer, especially since they have quick study, learn officer abilities and half the time? That seems really good. So I want to say yes and no. The problem is that some of the psionic already has enough to do, and things like domination, soulfire, null lands, void drift, they are all turn ending abilities. So if you want to have your high impact skills, you're not going to be using a command on that same turn. At the same time, if you focus more on the support abilities, like having the Bastion Aura, like providing null ward for your team, have a strong psi stat to mind merge someone on your team, I think it can work. I've had psionic officers in the past. The problem is the psionics come online a little bit later in the game. It's already hard to level them. They spend extra time in the tube learning psi skills, and then you're all also taking them out of action to learn officer skills. Yeah, it's in half the time, but it's a big time investment. So I think it can work. I wouldn't make a lot of psionic officer, but yeah, having one psionic officer certainly helps, and they are amazing once fully trained up at detecting faceless in your havens. So throwing them in there for 2 weeks probably roots out any faceless that are in there. So yeah, that's the general psionic guide. Again, keep in mind, probably bookmark this tree of requirements, so when you see the options that are available, and that you know what to pick in order to get something else later on. Like, don't be surprised, why does the game never offer me Void Rift if you just ignore Soul Steal the whole time? Because like, Soul Steal is not that great of an ability. Nah, pick it up if you want to get Void Rift. Also if you want to get Null Ward. That's kind of an easy trap to fall into, where you ignore Soul Steal and you never get those two offered. You can either take a screenshot right now of this tree, or just go to the Long War of the Chosen Discord, into the new player help channel, and it's a pinned message there with this exact tree. Alright, so that's it for the psionic class. And that's it for the class guides for Long War of the Chosen. I will be adding comments, pinned comments to previous class guides in case anything changes with future patches, trying to keep them as up-to-date as possible. And of course, if some new meta arises where everybody realizes, man, Slugshot Assaults are the bee's knees, then I might just make new guides. I don't think that's gonna happen. Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you next time.